Rochester in the road black, Whitco in their home white. It'll be Garrick and Bennett to jump. The ball is saved from going out of bounds by Korn, and Rochester takes possession. Alec Collins running the point for the Zebras. Whitco coming out man-to-man with a little trap on the wing. Hadashel dumps down low. His pass is taken away by the Whitco Wildcats, and Cumberland will bring it up the floor. Rochester will be in a man-to-man defense. Near side to Weber. Now top to Powell. Swings quickly to Cumberland, high on the right side. Lob pass down low to Bennett against Odell. Pass is knocked away, picked up by Holland. Zebras also in a man-to-man. Odell played good post defense, knocked that pass away.
Yeah, they're pretty short down low with Kennedy on the bench for the illness, but the Rochester Zebras held their ground there in the post. And now offensively, they go into our right. Odell top of the key, swings right side to Garrick. Garrick behind the arc on the wing, has his ball taken away by Weber. And now Weber gives off to Stoddard, who gives to Cumberland. Cumberland across the timeline, where he'll be picked up by Holland. Now top to Bennett, is taken away by Odell to Hadashel. No look pass to Odell, goes to the basket, pass, shot is blocked. The putback by Garrick is no good, and the rebound to Whitco and Bennett. Thank you. Now to Stoddard, he'll go coast to coast. He'll throw one up with the glass, no good. Ball tipped around, Holland picks it up. No score here early on at Whitco High School. A minute and a half into the game. And Rochester the basketball going to our right. Holland top of the key. Works against Cumberland, the man-to-man defense. Holland out on the right wing. Couple of dribbles. Bounce pass through Korn between the rings at the volleyball line. Seth Korn dribbles to his left. Switches directions. Now back to his right. Cut off at the top of the key. Down to Holland way outside left. Now to Garrick. Ball tipped away. And Holland somehow gets it back to Hadashel in the corner. Jacob in the paint, kicks it out right wing to Odell. Now to Seth Korn for a quick 15-footer, and it's good.
Good ball movement by Zebras. You can tell a little tweak of the offense. They've opened the floor up a little bit more, a lot more passing, cutting, and screening away from the ball. And
somebody's looking for a shot.
Yeah, I think everybody, all five Zebras touched the ball in that possession.
Rochester strikes first. They're up 2-0 with a 5:45 to play in the first quarter. Lot pass down low to Bennett. Turnaround jumper. The baseline's no good. Ball fought for. Garrett comes out of there with the basketball and out of Korn.
Zebras going to have to play good team defense, which they are. Swarm the post inside, but then be ready to recover on a kickout.
They're doing a great job shutting off the post. As Steph Korn takes the 18-footer off the back of the RM, no good. In a man-to-man defense to finish that thought, they're really sagging down to help down low on Bennett. 5:15 to play, first quarter. Rochester up 2-0.
Now they switch to a 2-3 zone.
Turn out of Weber. I think Whitco's coach Wetzer said that Weber is shooting 66% from the floor. He has the top of the key. Now to Stoddard on the elbow. Baseline to Cumberland. Down low to Bennett. Bennett's shot over the triple team is no good. Gets his own rebound. The putback is good. Rochester did a good job blocking out. Bennett just went up over the back of the Zebra defender. Garrick breaks the press. No look pass down low to Odell. His layup on the glass is no good. And the rebound to Weber. Now to Cumberland. 4:40 to play, first quarter. We're tied at 2 here at Whitkill High School. 2-3 zone by the Zebras. Stoddard on the wing, left side. Gives the baseline to Bennett. Takes it out to Stoddard, high on the left side. Now right wing to Weber. Fakes the three from about 15 feet behind the arc. Now to Stoddard at the elbow to Cumberland. He'll fire a long three for the Wildcats. No good. The weak side rebound to Powell. His putback's no good. Gets his own rebound back. And now we're going to have a foul coming against the Zebras as Powell and Garrett got tied up.
I think they're going to give that foul to Al Garrick. Both guys battling for the ball. But they're going to give that foul to Alec Garrick. That's his first, Zebra's first.
4:20 to play in the first quarter. We're tied at 2. And quickly, the Whitco Wildcats strike for their fourth point.
That was 43, Bennett off the inbound pass. Zebra's lost him. He just cut right down the lane, got a layup.
4:05 to play, first quarter. 4-2 Whitco, and against the full court press, the Zebras get it across the timeline. Garrick quickly on the baseline to Korn, back to Hadashel. Jacob Hadashel back to Korn, left baseline. He drives the baseline hard, throws the glass, shot up for the glass, no good, and a big rebound to Alex Stoddard and the Whitco Wildcats.
Seth kind of fading away from the basket. He made a nice baseline drive, but then drifted away from the basket instead of going towards it, left it short.
Pretty hard shot as well from about 5 feet away. Weber high on the left side. Now gives to Stoddard. Quickly sends right side to Cumberland. And then throws it in the backcourt, and Stoddard is going to be called for over the back, and Rochester going to get it back. Down by two with 3.5 to play in the first quarter.
Luke Cannon again check in for the first time. Seth Korn going to go to the bench.
3:34 to play in the first period. Wichita up 4-2, and the Zebras of the basketball.
Looks like 1-3-1 by Wichita.
And here comes the trap as Holland not yet crosses the timeline and throws it out of bounds, and Wichita is going to get it back. And before he even got into the trap, Wichita forces a turnover.
Right, just tried to throw that baseline pass just too high and threw it out of bounds. Second turnover for the Zebras.
Rochester in a 2-3 zone. Cumberland runs the point for the Wildcats. Top of the key. Nazis pass tipped out of bounds by Derek. It'll stay with the Wildcats right in front of the Rochester bench. And Taylor Medina, who had a great holiday tournament, checks in for the first time tonight. He's got three quarters. John O'Dell will sit.
And here we go with our young lineup here. We've got two juniors, two sophomores, and a freshman for the Zebras.
4-2 Wichita. 3:10 to play first quarter. The Wildcat going to our left. Stoddard, top of the key, swings left side behind the arc to Cumberland. Now right wing to Weber, who fires a long three, and it's good. He's almost standing out of bounds and chucked that three. Now Wichita up 7-2. Full court press by the Wildcats. Holland brings it up the floor against Cumberland, and Cumberland's going to be called for the blocking foul. It'll be out of bounds to Rochester in front of their own bench, going to our right with 2:50 to play in the first quarter.
Looks like Whitco's going to try to pressure young Alec Holland as much as they can, even if they're not really pressure behind it, at least make him handle the ball with as much pressure as possible.
He's being guided by Cumberland, who is a junior for the Whitco Wildcats. Alec Garrick has his three-ball block, and the rebound goes ahead to Weber, and he is fouled going to the basket. It'll be on the floor. Nope. The official on this side says it calls it on the floor. The official on the far side from us calls it on the shot. So that's going to send Weber to the line for two for the Wildcats.
Interesting. The guy who makes the call called it on the floor. The guy at half court tried to say it was two. Thankfully, the guy who made the call is going to overrule the other guy, and then Richfield's going to take the ball in bounds as he should. First foul for Al Collins.
Weber, baseline right, looks to get it in, makes it to Cumberland, gets it into Stoddard, fakes the three, drives to the basket, dumps down little Powell. Powell in the paint, kicks it outside to Bennett. Bennett's floater over Kennedy on the way short. Kennedy with the rebound. And gives to Alec Holland. Rochester running to our right, down by five with 2:25 to play in the first quarter. Jacob Hadashell, left side, has his pocket picked by Cumberland. Cumberland, right side of the floor, goes up for the right-handed layup. It is no good. And Weber's a rebound. He's going to be fouled on the shot, and he'll go to the line to shoot two.
That's tough foul there. That's Alec Holland. That's his second one. That's going to send him to the bench, I believe. Zebra's third.
Sorry, Tony, you can already tell. 2:17 to play in the first quarter. Wichita with quick hands.
Yeah, they're very aggressive. Just playing the dribble, not even the passing lanes, but they're trying to steal the dribble.
Yeah.
And Zebras have to be aware of that. They've got to make that adjustment.
Weber misses the first free throw, and Coach Reinhold goes to a line change as Seth Corey comes back in. Cy Holland in for the first time, and Carter Screeton comes in for the Rochester Zebras, setting as Hadashell, Kennedy, and Alec Holland.
Trying to get with Alec Holland sitting down, you've got to get other complimentary ball handlers. Nobody can handle like Alec can, but you've got to get the Streetons and the Cy Hollins and Alec Garrick's back in to help handle the ball a little bit.
Weber misses both free throws, and the lead is still 5 for Wichita with 2:05 to play in the first quarter. Cy Holland holds on the right side, gives to Alec Garrick in the lane. Cut off by the defense, back to Holland on the right wing, top to Streeton. And now Coach Reinhold will use a 30-second timeout. You're listening to Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
Come check out the amazing deals at the Winning Edge in Rochester. With the winter sports season here, they have all the gear you need. The January specials, and to get you in the mood for spring, 25% off all bats and 50% off all bags, backpacks, and duffels. The Winning Edge offers major apparel brands, Adidas duffel and backpacks, Under Armour and Russell apparel, and so much more. Visit their webpage, thewinedge.com, or their Facebook page. Call 574-223-6090. Quality products, unique customizing options, and friendly service from the Winning Edge, Ryle Place Drive in Rochester.
Zebra Basketball, WROI.
1:58 to play in the first quarter. Wichita leading here at Wichita High School 7-2, and Cy Holland being double teamed in the backcourt. Jump pass to Korn. Loaded to Medina. He has a shot block. Taylor gets it back. Has a shot block again. A Cumberland picks up the loose basketball for the Wildcats. And Alec Garrick just picked up the second personal foul.
That's going to be Alec's second. So our two Alecs both have two fouls. Alec Holland already on the bench, which is, we talked about, you're trying to work on different lineups. But I don't know if Coach Reinhold worked on too many lineups over break with Alec Holland sitting the bench for extended time, as he will. And now Alec Holland joins them. Ball handling's at a premium for the Zebras right now.
Yeah, really, the guard right now is Carter Screeden. Cy Holland also can handle the basketball as John O'Dell comes back into the game for Alec Garrick. 1:30 to play, first quarter. Now we got a 5-second violation. Great defense from the far side by Taylor Medina to force that turnover. The Zebras going to get it back down by 5 with 90 seconds of play in the first period.
Good defense. Powell picked up his dribble. Medina, you know, some kids body him up and maybe get a foul there. He kept his distance, but he also kept his pressure on. Trace the ball, uses long arms, and force a 5-second call.
Screen runs the point for Rochester. High on the left side for the Zebras. Goes around the double team, loses his footage. And the loose ball is picked up by the Wildcats. And Whitco will use a timeout as Alex Stoddard grabs a loose basketball. It's a 60-second break. You're listening to Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
Smith Farm Store is your locally owned winter headquarters. Whether your winter needs include a snowblower, stove, or furnace, or you're in the market for a new steel chainsaw or gun safe, or you just need the basics like a chimney sweeping log or ice melt, Smith Farm Store is the only stop you need to make. Smith Farm Store of Rochester has moved next door to 151 Rochester Plaza in the old Kroger building. Smith Farm Store, your friendly local hardware store in Rochester and Plymouth.
New Holland T7000 Series tractors from New Holland Rochester take tractor performance to new heights with groundbreaking power, best-in-class hydraulics, and high-visibility horizon cab. These 135 to 180 PTO horsepower tractors offer the new fast-steer turning option, a must-have feature for row crop or loader work. It lets you make a full right or left turn with only a 10-degree nudge of the steering wheel. Step up to a new level of performance with the New Holland T7000 tractor from New Holland Rochester, Highway 25 South.
Zebra Basketball, WROI.
1:10 to play in the first quarter. Whitco still leading 7-2. We went about 3 minutes here in a scoring drought, and John O'Dell just picked up a reach-in foul, as he came over the back or around the back of Bennett, picked up that foul. It'll be Whitco basketball to bounce baseline right.
A couple big storylines here. Rochester struggling with some turnovers. Obviously, offensively, we played about 7 minutes, and they've only got 2 points. Turnovers have been a problem, and then foul trouble. That's the Zebras' fifth team foul, and already Alec Holland and Alec Garrick have two fouls. That's O'Dell's first.
Yeah. Minute 5 to play, first quarter. Whitco with the basketball going to our left. Alex Stoddard, who's been here about 10 years for Whitco Wildcats, probably has, I don't know how, he probably has about 20 or 30 letters, gives to Weber, who fires a long three, no good, and corner the rebound. He's been here forever.
Did he play last year, though? Wasn't there a returner who did not play last year? Is he the one, somebody I thought who had been playing did not play last year?
No, I think Stoddard played.
Did he? Okay. But yeah, you're right, that name's been around forever.
He's finally a senior. 35 seconds to play, first quarter. Rochester with the basketball. Taylor Medina gives right side to Screeden. Screeden drives against the defense, kicks it out to Korn. He takes the long 18-footer, and it goes. Seth Korn has all four of the Zebra points, and it's 7-4. Whitco with 20 seconds to play, first quarter.
Nice assist by Carter. He drove to set up Seth. If he doesn't drive the ball hard and under control and make that kick out, Seth doesn't have the open shot.
Weber in the corner against the double team. Dribbles away from the double team. Has a pass tipped out of bounds by Cy Holland. It'll stay with Whitco right in front of the Rochester bench with 9 seconds to play, first quarter.
Seaver's going to need some big minutes out of Cy Holland and Carter Street with Alec Holland on the bench. Those guys are going to have to play good defense without fouling and set the offense.
A lot of rust for the Rochester Zebras. 5 seconds. Stoddard to Weber with 4. Weber drives around defense with 2. Dumps down little. Stoddard, his jumper. The buzzer is good. After 1, Whitco leads 9-4. You're listening to Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
Being a parent has never been tougher. Life just offers too many choices and temptations. Many families find help by becoming affiliated with friends at their place of worship, and that is a great help. If you find your life is offering more questions than answers, why not join us at Grace United Methodist Church? We have services on Saturday at 5:30 p.m. and Sunday at 9:30 a.m. Child care is provided at both services. Our church is located at 7th and Jefferson Streets in Rochester. We welcome you to become a part of our church family.
WROI Rochester.
Jennings Insurance, your professional Pekin Insurance agency located in Argus and Rochester, believes in the game of life. It pays to make sure you're safely covered with insurance. They can help you cover all the bases, whether it's auto, homeowners, life, business, health, or an annuity. At Jennings Insurance, they'll help you compare rates and prices. That's Jennings Insurance and Pekin teaming up to help you plan ahead for protection against those unexpected plays in the game of life.
Zebra Basketball, WROI.
Back at Whitco High School, getting ready to go to the second quarter with the Whitco Wildcats leading 9-4. And Tony, as we went to break there, Weber did a great job. I think Rochester was really focused on Weber taking that last-second shot, and he found a wide-open Alex Stoner cutting to the basket.
Yeah, there's some weak side non-help there. I said as the driver went in first, the help wasn't quite there, and everybody kind of stood and watched, and he dropped that pass off for a wide-open layup. Tough finish that way. I mean, if you get a stop there down 7-4, now you're down 9-4. Not a huge deal, but just a little momentum boost that goes again for Whitco.
Yeah. A lot of rust right now for the Rochester Zebras. You can tell they've been off for about 2 weeks. The Wildcats start the second quarter of the basketball. Cumberland on the baseline to Kessie and has his pass tipped out of bounds by the Zebra defense. It will stay with Whitco baseline left. Again, 9-4 Wildcats with 15 seconds gone here in the second quarter. Tony Stasiak, I'm David Musselman. Whitco going to our left. Kessie dumps down little Powell. Powell against Medina. Kicks it to the baseline to Cumberland. Quickly top to Weber. Now left side to Kessie. Back to Weber, top of the key. Rochester's had their fingers on the basketball the last two passes. Now to Cumberland. Cross-court pass to Kessie. Fakes a three against the double team. Gives top to Weber. Rochester in a 2-3 zone. Now to Cumberland. Cumberland between the rings. Outside to Weber. Way, a long way away from the basket. Now to Kessie on the left wing. Top to Cumberland. Quickly right wing to Weber. Long three again from the from the first row of the bleachers. The basket's no good, but an offensive rebound to Kessie. Now to Cumberland. 9-4 Whitco. Has a pass tipped away by Cy Holland. He picks up loose basketball. Going to our right, he'll go to the basket. He's shot good and a foul. The bucket's good. And Cy Holland will go to the free throw line to shoot one. And trying to cut this lead to two with 7:03 to play in the first half.
Nice job. Cy got the deflection out ahead, went and chased it down, and then kept his body control and drew the blocking foul. That foul's going to be on number five, Dylan Cumberland. That's his second, which is big because he's been the most aggressive Whitco Wildcat up top of their little half-court trap, and now he sits with two fouls.
He, too, has been their main ball handler to this point as well. So, Cy Holland.
One of the things you look for here is, and like you said, the Zebras do look rusty as Cy Holland misses that free throw. The Zebras do look a little rusty, but you can't really count for the schedule. Their Christmas turnaround was before Christmas. Whitco played once on the 27th, once on the 28th. That's a huge advantage at this point.
Yeah, and it shows. You're right. Taylor Medina takes the ball away from Bennett and gives a screen. 9-6 Whitco with 6:40 to play in the first half. Rochester going to our right. Medina high on the left side for the Zebras. On the wing, now to Korn, now right side of Holland. Dumps down little Medina, loses the basketball, and Taylor Medina on a hustle play is going to be called for a foul as he fouls Kessie in front of the Whitco Wildcat bench.
We've seen that several times this year from the Zebras. It's the frustration fouls. Turnover there, and, you know, realistically, what are you going to do 82 feet from the basket? I mean, he was trying to it was a bad pass. It wasn't Taylor's fault. He should have been led to the basket. He fumbles the ball away, and, you know, he just bodies the guy up 82 feet from the basket. Those are the ones that are probably most frustrating for coach because you like the aggressiveness.
Right.
But what are you going to do 82 feet from the basket?
You're right. Especially your team in a little bit of foul difficulty already.
Whitco shooting free throws the rest of the half, and there's 6:16 left in this quarter.
9-6, Whitco. Rochester, make that Whitco has it. Rochester still in that 2-3 zone.
Big 6 minutes for Zebras. If they can sustain and stay in this game over the next 6 minutes, then you pick up Garrick and Holland back in the second half, and then I think the rust kind of gets eliminated. You just got to survive this first half, knock off that rust, and I think that if they can be in this game in the second half, I think it's a whole different thing, but they've got to survive this next 6 minutes.
9-6 Whitco. Stoddard with the basketball, sends right wing to Weber, fakes a three, and drives around the defense on the baseline, and Taylor Medina just picked up foul number two. Probably Odell should have picked up the foul there, but he got away with one.
Yeah, Odell's hit looked a little more vicious. block or charge, whatever, no call. And then Medina comes over, rotates, which again adds to the Zebras' woes. He's the third Zebra with two fouls. Medina joined Alec Holland and Alec Garrett with two fouls. And again, Whitco shooting fouls the rest of the half.
Tony, let's go back to the JV game a minute. Taylor Medina, Rex told me at the beginning, as we're in the locker room during the pregame, I asked him how many quarters Taylor was going to play tonight, and he said two quarters of the JV game. You got foul problems right now for the Rochester Zebras, Taylor Medina being one of them. But as I get to the question, as Whitco hits their first free throw, as Weber hits the first one, he'll have one more. As the third quarter starts, Rochester is up handily. I don't know. It was like 20-point lead at halftime. Taylor Medina comes in and plays 2 minutes, so they blow a quarter, which now, if they had him for four quarters, that could be a big deal.
Yeah, that looms large, and trust me, I've been there myself, and you're trying to gamble the quarter sometimes, and it seems like every time you think, oh, you know, let's just get some experience, and you save quarters, you don't need them in the varsity, and then when you don't save quarters in JV, you end up needing them in varsity. It's tough to make that call. Sometimes you wish they'd play the varsity game first so you knew how many quarters you need, and then the leftovers just go to the JV.
John O'Dell misses his long three-pointer. Alex Stoddard, the rebound, gives to Weber. Rochester to 2-3 zone. Stoddard now to Kesser in the right corner. Testing out is Stoddard at the elbow to Powell. And Powell is fouled on the reach-in, and so that's going to send Gabe Powell, the 6'3 senior, to the line for one of the bonus.
The other thing that this does, not just the foul trouble, but this puts, the foul trouble puts more of an onus on Luke Cannaday. He's not quite healthy. He's going to have to play extended minutes because right now, if you look at the Zebra bench, there's four guys on the bench. Well, Kevin Harris hasn't come in yet, so you still have Harris, but of the guys who played, three of the four guys sitting on the bench have two fouls. That's Luke's first.
Free throw by Powell is no good.
He may not have the stamina, but he's going to have to play big minutes really right now.
He grabs a big board there for the Rochester Zebras. Zebras down by four with 5 minutes to play in the first half. O'Dell, about 10 feet behind the three-point line, gives the Kennedy between the rings of the volleyball line. Luke stands against Bennett, against the man-to-man defense, and travels. Tries to back the way in, lost his footing, and traveled, and is going to give the ball back to the Whitco Wildcats, who lead by four as Rex Reinholt sheds the jacket.
Speaking from experience, this Whitco gym has not been kind to Rochester coaches. Coach Malko would say the same thing. This is not one of our favorite places to come and coach, I can tell you that.
Hannah Shaw has a shot knocked away, and Luke Kennedy picks up the rebound and goes in hard, and he'll be fouled on the shot. He'll go to the line to shoot two. Carter Streeton started that break by just ripping the ball away from Alex Stoddard. Then gave the court, who fed ahead to Hadashell, had his pass basketball taken away from him going to the basket. Kennedy there to pick up the loose ball and foul on the shot, so he'll go to the line to shoot two. Looking to cut this lead to two. First one's good by the big man, Luke Kennedy. One more coming for the Zebras. 4:41 to play, first half, 10-7. Whitco here at Whitco High School. Tony Stasiak, I'm David Musselman. Kennedy with a second one. It is good again.
Well, at least so far, his illness hasn't affected his legs on his early free throw.
Right.
That's a nice-looking stroke.
4.5 to play, first half. Whitco by two. Stoddard around the defense to Kessie. Sends right side to Weber. Back to Stoddard, top of the key. Stoddard around the defense of the elbow to Kessie. Looks at the three on the baseline. Passes it up against the double team. Now to Stoddard. Stoddard loses the handle. The screen again. And we're going to have a screener looking for a timeout. He's going to get it. Rochester will use a 30-second timeout. You're listening to Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
It's not how you start, but how you finish. At Braun Chrysler Dodge Jeep and Ram of Winnemac, we want you to finish big with the Big Finish 2012. There's still time for huge savings on 2012 models. And come check out our lineup of impressive new 2013 vehicles arriving daily, including the technologically advanced Chrysler 300, impressive Dodge Dart, and rugged Jeeps and Rams. Take advantage of the Big Finish 2012 at Braun Chrysler Dodge Jeep and Ram, US 35 South in Winnemac. Online at BraunChryslerDodgeJeep.com.
Zebra Basketball, WROI.
4:20 to play in the second quarter. Whitco leading 10-8. And after the Rochester timeout and the Whitco turnover, they'll have the basketball in front of their own bench. Holland, side that is, gets it into Carter. Streeton works against Stoddard in the backcourt. Man-to-man defense now by the Wildcats.
Out of corn, Cy Holland just checked in for Luke Kanade. Luke got 2 minutes there. He came in at about the six-minute mark. He's out about the four-minute. I think that's what you're going to kind of have to do here, or maybe him and Cy.
Odell for three is no good on the back of the iron. Stoddard to the rebound. Under four to play in the first half. Whitco by two. They've got the basketball going to our left, and Rochester's been in that 2-3 zone, Tony, for a while.
Yeah, it's a combination of the foul situations and the lack of height. Probably the best move at this point, and it has taken Whitco out of their offensive rhythm a little bit. You know, Zebra's only down two, playing well. We said they had to survive the last 6 minutes. So far, they're halfway through and looking okay.
Bennett's leaner in the lane is good, and that lead now to four to Whitco.
Bennett has six himself,
and it's 12-8 Wildcats. Out of shell. Against Weber in the backcourt, gives to Korn against Bennett in the man-to-man defense. Korn tries to go around Bennett, cut off on the baseline, gives to Cy Holland. His finger roll in the lane is no good. Tessie with a rebound, now to Stoddard. 3:10 to play first half. Whitco up 12-8. Tessie in the corner against the double team. Back to Stoddard, now to Bennett the elbow. Down low to Powell, taken away by Korn. Turnover Whitco, and Seth Korn gives to Carter Screeton. Rochester going to our right, down by four. Streeton walks it through the center circle against the man-to-man defense. Now to Odell, high on the right side to Seth Korn. Korn against Bennett. Drives left, cut off by the defense. Pulls up from 15 feet. It's good. The lead is cut to two again. It's 12-10. Seth Korn with six. Rochester's only lead in this half has been 2-0. Jesse against the 2-3 or the trap. To Weber, goes around the defense in the baseline. His leaner on the baseline is no good. Powell, the rebound. He kicks it outside to Stoddard. Stoddard on the baseline to Weber. Wide open three. Left side is in and out. No good. Ball being tipped around. And Whitco knocks the basketball out of bounds, but they had another opportunity for another third and fourth offensive rebound on that trip.
Yeah, they were unofficially, I'd say they got about, seems like five or six offensive rebounds this half. Which, again, playing a zone is tough because you're not always sure who exactly your responsibility is to block out. And the Zebras have had their adventures on the defensive board, yeah, as it is, even playing man-to-man. So you're still in a position. You're only down two with 2 minutes to go. You got to finish this half and hopefully be within two. If not, the lead would be great at this point.
Both Alex back into the game. Alec Garrett goes to the basket hard. His basket, his shot rolls off the rim. Stoddard picks up the loose ball rebound and drives to our left. Stoddard then is fouled going to the basket, and Alex Stoddard will go to the free throw line and shoot free throws as Jacob Hadashell just picks up a personal foul.
That's going to be Jacob's first and the Zebras' ninth of the half. Stoddard going to the line where he's played 0 for 1 so far today. Kanade going to come back in, so it looks like Kanade's on a couple, off a couple.
Yeah.
And Carter Screeton comes back in. Alec Holland comes back out, so, you know, it's a little bit of a gamble, but Alec Garrett also coming back out. So the two Alex got in, got a couple minutes on the floor, gave some guys some breathers, but able to get off the floor with only two fouls is big.
Stoddard has one of the bonus for the Wildcats. First one is in and out and back in. They'll have one more. Pushes this lead back to three. It's been as big as four. And Stoddard can push it back to that lead here with another freebie. 1:50 to play first half. 13-10 Whitco. Second one by Stoddard is no good off the back of the iron. And the rebound is Seth Korn. Boy, Bennett climbed the back of Odell, no call. Streeton, top of the key, gives the corner behind the arc, right side. 1:40 to play. Luke Kanade then loses the basketball as he backs his way in, out of bounds, and it'll go back to the Whitco Wildcats.
That might be an instance of your rust and not climbing back into things. Luke, you know, he's been out a little bit. Probably, you know, if this is before break, he makes that catch and finishes strong, and we're coming down the other end. But with him being out sometime, I think that's a little bit of a rust and a fumble.
He had Bennett on his right hip. I mean, the shot was wide open if he could have grabbed the ball. The Cumberland back in the game for the Wildcats with 1:30 to play in the second quarter. Whitco up by three. The ball's turned over. Luke makes that. John Odell will go in for the right-handed layup. It's up and good. 13-12. The Wildcats lead is down to one with 1:10 to play in the first half. 2-3 zone still by the Zebras. Weber crosses the timeline, gives high on the right side to Stoddard. Stoddard picks up his dribble, gives to Bennett the elbow, in the corner to Weber. Weber around the defense, now the wing, right side to Stoddard. Stoddard around the defense, gives him the corner to Cumberland. Back to Weber for a long three is no good. And the weak side rebound to Hadashell, gives a head to Screeton. Carter Screeton fakes, goes up for the shot, has it blocked, And Powell has a rebound. Screen somehow takes it away. Gives to Odell. Odell on the left baseline. Cut off by the defense. Now pulls it back out with 39 seconds to play in the first half. Out of Screen with 35. 13-12 Witco as the clock runs and ticks away here in the second quarter. Screen with 28. Dribbles to his left. Is out to Hadashell with 25. Jacob Hadashell fakes the pass. Gets Bennett off the floor. Now dribbles to his left. Gives to John O'Dell near the timeline with 15. Odell against Stoddard, drives right side in the paint, kicks it in the corner to Kennedy. Now right side to Streeton with 10. Streeton dribbles away from Weber with 6, pushes direction, is fouled with 5.5 to play in the first half. Of course, it will not be a shooting foul, as that's only the 14th foul by the Waco Wildcats.
First on Weber, like you said, the old NBA term, fouls to give. It's only the 14th foul, so the Zebras aren't going to be shooting an inbound the ball with 5.5.
Hadashell gets it into Streeton. Streeton around the defense. Down low to one over Kennedy. His shot's good. As we go to halftime, Rochester regains the lead at 14-13. You're listening to Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
Zebra Basketball, WROI.
Back at Rochester High School as we start the third quarter. The Zebras will start with the basketball going to our left. Hadashell will look to get it in and finally does it for the five count to Odell. He gives to Streeton.
Witco comes out man-to-man.
Streeton starts the second half, gives to Odell, now top to Korn. Korn top of the key. Back to Odell, high on the right side, around the defense. Gives to Garrigan, the left to the baseline. He drives the basket, has shot blocked from behind by Weber. Picked up by Powell, now ahead to Cumberland. 14-13, Rochester, as we start the third quarter. Out to Weber, deep in the left corner. Back to make that to Cumberland. Pass knocked away, picked up by Hadashell, and Jacob brings it to our left.
Both coaches have to be equally frustrated at this point. You come out, talk about your offense, and they both turn it over on first possession.
Oh, and Garrick got away with a charge, I think, because Bennett was had pretty good ground.
Well, maybe it was tails on that coin.
You're right.
Foul's going to be on Bennett. That's only his first, and, of course, Witco's first of the half.
Hadashell gets it inbounds to Odell right near the timeline. He works top of the key against Powell. In the paint, throws up a prayer. No good. Stoddard with the rebound out of Cumberland. Cumberland brings it up the floor for Witco right through the center circle. Rochester back in that 2-3 zone. A minute gone in the third quarter. Rochester by one. In the paint to Powell. Powell's pass is tipped away and stolen. And now we're going to reach in on, I believe, Gabe Powell. And it's going to go back to Rochester on the Witco turnover.
Yep, he signaled 31. Gabe Powell, that's his first. And quick two fouls for Witco. Carter Streeton gets a start. Holland's still on the bench. Maybe a little tip of the hat to Carter for playing so well in the second quarter. Give him a chance to start the second half.
And as soon as you say that, Streeton has his pocket picked by Cumberland, who goes in easily for an uncontested layup. And Witco back up 15-14. Hadashell against Stoddard in the backcourt. Double team now to Streeton. Rochester with the numbers. Streeton, no-look pass to Odell. Wide open three on the way from the corner. Is way off the mark. No good. And the ball is knocked out of bounds by Bennett. Oh, it's going to go back to Rochester. Bennett was the only one near the rebound. It's going to go back to Rochester. Going to go back to Witco to say Rochester knocked it out of bounds.
That was the official who called the blocking foul that we thought might have been a charge, so maybe that's his makeup.
Good call. Heads this time, huh?
Mm-hmm.
Cumberland, right side to Weber, behind the arc, back to Cumberland, middle before, now left side to Stoddard. High on the left side for the Wildcats, 2-3 zone by the Zebras to Weber.
You know, we talked about Rochester surviving their foul trouble, but keep in mind, Cumberland went out with two fouls in the second quarter as well, and he led their defense, got a lot of turnovers on steals, and the offense kind of bogged down once he left the game as well.
You're right. And another turnover on Witco, they just chucked it out of bounds, so Rochester are going to get it back. Down by one, 6 minutes to play in the third.
1-3-1 half-court trap by Witco. Rochester runs this themselves, so you wouldn't think it would bother them all that much.
Seth Korn to the baseline. Pull up 15-footer off the side of the backboard. No good. And Cumberland the rebound. Cumberland runs down the left side of the floor. Right-handed layup is good. And Witco up 17-14. And boy, if they want to run, they can do that. They've got some athletes and quick ones at that.
Yeah, very impressed with Cumberland. You know, his ability to pick pockets on the defensive end and get out in transition on the offensive end. The speed that nobody except maybe Alec Holland has for the Zebras.
and he's still on the bench. He's been there a lot of the second quarter and here to start the second half. Derek's shot from inside 5 feet, no good. And the rebound to Powell, and Powell and Kennedy then tied up, and it should go to the Wildcats, alternating possession, and it will.
Okay, Luke Kennedy comes out, and, you know, that's another situation, another great look by the Zebras. Point blank for Garrett, just not getting those easy shots to fall. They could easily have probably, you know, another 5 to 10 points just off some of those easy bunnies they missed.
Kennedy's replaced by Odell, who's in the basketball game. And speaking of Odell, Weber takes a shot over Odell for three, and it's good. And now the biggest lead of the night at Wico at six. It's 20-14. It's 5 minutes to play in the third quarter.
That's a little breakdown. I'm sure Coach Reinholz doesn't ever want Mr. Weber to be that wide open on the three-point line.
Adeshel's layup is good. Knifing through the zone, he gets the easy look, and it cuts the lead to four.
First two for Jacob.
20-16, 4:40 to play in the third. Weber feeds down low to Bennett. Bennett over Odell. Good. Nice turnaround baby hook by Weber. And the Wildcats back up by six. With 4.5 to play in the third quarter. Tony Stasiak, I'm David Musselman. Screening around the defense. Out to Garrick High on the right side. Garrick around the defense. Cut off in the lane. Out to Odell. Odell. Leaner over the defense is good as it sneaks over the front of the rim and goes through.
It's only Odell's fourth point of the night.
Boy, he hasn't even been in the same zip code on those three-pointers.
Yeah, he's got to get back and get in an inside game like that. Attacking the basket, I think, is his best move tonight.
Bennett kicks it out to Weber behind the arc, fakes the three. Nice job by Hadashel, staking with him. Cumberland's leaner lane is no good. Steps corner of the rebound and gives to Streeton. 22-18, Witko with 3:45 to play in the third.
Witko back to man-to-man.
Screen going to our left to the center circle, cut off on the wing. Oh, Hadashel throws an elbow and lands it against Stoddard. Out of Odell, top of the key to Garrick.
You guys may have had some football battles, like some of these guys that are two-sport athletes.
Right, you're right. Odell's 15-footer is high off the glass. Good. Tim Duncan is patenting that shot.
Love that. Mr. Fundamental.
That's right.
Well, it's hard to use the backboard in this game.
Lead is cut to two. It's 22-20, Witko. 2-3 zone again by the Zebras. Cumberland quickly left side to Stoddard. Stoddard behind the arc on the wing. Top to Cumberland, back to Stoddard. Fakes the three, drives around the defense, goes hard to the basket. Shot blocked by Korn. Picked up by Seth, now ahead to Garrick. Rochester with the numbers. Alec Garrick then pulls it back outside and will set up the offense as he gets to Hadashel between the rings and the volleyball line. Hadashel around the defense, kicks it back outside to Garrick. 2:45 to play, third quarter, 22-20 Witko. Garrick goes hard to the basket, has his shot blocked by Powell. Ball loose, Garrick picks it up. Powell has it as he gets it away from Garrick and gives to Weber. Witko by two. Outside to Cumberland. Now to Stoddard, to a wide-open Weber. Fakes a three around Odell. Goes to the basket over Korn. His shot, jumper's good.
Mr. Weber now has 9 points.
24-20 Witko, 2:15 to play in the third. And Coach Reinhold's going to send in Cy Holland, Alec Holland, and Medina at the next opportunity. Garrick's jumper from the free throw line is good. Nice soft shot by Alec Garrick. And the lead cut to two.
Well, the offense has definitely picked up this quarter. Both teams.
24-22. Witko on top with under 2 minutes to play in the third quarter. Weber feeds down low to Bennett against the double team. Kicks it out to a wide open Stoddard. Stoddard just inside the arc. The long jumper short. And Powell the rebound. And actually, they're going to... Powell's going to be fouled, I believe, as he was falling out of bounds by either Garrick or Korn. We'll wait to see who that's going to be whistled against.
That's going to be on Garrick. It's his third. And only the first team foul, Rochester, in the second half.
Garrick, Screeton, and Odell make that Hadashel comes out of the game. It'll be Witko basketball baseline left underneath their own basket with a minute 45 to play in the first third quarter. The pass is tipped out of bounds by Medina, and we'll see with Witko. We'll try it again, baseline left.
Alec Holland probably only got about 3 or 4 minutes of court time that entire first half.
Law pass is taken away by Medina. Now it's loose again on the floor. Powell comes out of there with it. He throws up a shot. It's no good. Rebound tipped out to Stoddard. Stoddard in the paint. Leaner over Korn is no good. Powell with a rebound. Witko shot on the way is good. And a foul. three or four offensive boards on that trip for the Wildcats. And that shot just put the Wildcats back up by four with one free throw coming for Powell.
I think they're going to get that foul on Taylor Medina. That's going to be his third. Another Zebra that has battled foul trouble and hasn't been on the court very often.
Powell at the free throw line for one. Free throw on the way is no good. And Core to the rebound. 26-22 Witco. Minute 25 to play in the third. The Zebras have it coming to our left. Alec Holland, who's seen as well, limited playing time with the basketball top of the key. Pass right side to Korn. Korn behind the arc about 5 feet against Benton, the man-to-man defense. Now Cy Holland top of the key. Ball is loose. Cy Holland, and then it loses it out of bounds. Nope, they're going to say last touch by Alex Stoddard. It'll stay with the Zebras across court near the timeline.
That's got to throw a bounce pass there. That guy's cutting at you. A bounce pass is a lot easier to handle than that bullet over your head.
A minute 10 to play third quarter. Cy Holland gets it into Alec Holland. Cousins, in case you're wondering. Alec against Cumberland, man-to-man defense. Cy on the baseline. Couple of dribbles cut off by the defense. Got to get rid of it. Finally does to Odell, top of the key. John just inside the arc near the free throw line. His jumper's good. 26-24.
John's picking up this quarter. That's the 6 points of the quarter, eight for the game.
He's going to need to get hot. 40 seconds to play in the third.
Zebra's trapping a little bit. That was a 2-3 zone trap.
Cy Holland picks up the loose ball. He'll go in. The shot no good. The putback by Alec. Holland is good, and we're tied at 26. 30 seconds to play in the third quarter. And we're going to have stoppage of play, and then Witco was calling a play that looks like timeout.
I think they were trying to say maybe there was a deflection or something that, I don't know if he's trying to call a play or telling the referee the ball got deflected, but it wouldn't have mattered because the Zebras recovered it. It couldn't be over and back on the Zebras. They deflected it into the...
Yeah, you're right. What was he complaining about? You're right.
The Zebras a chance to set up a defense, though. 2-1-2 trap.
Thanks, Coach. 20 seconds to play in the third. We're tied at 26. Skip past the Weber. Wide open three in the corner. He is nope. Odell with a rebound ahead of Holland. Holland against Stoddard with 13 seconds. Now pulls up, gives to Odell with 9. John kicks it out to Cy Holland with 7. Now to Alec Holland with 6. Holland on the left side with 4. Got to get rid of it with 2. Leaner at the buzzer is no good. After 3, we're tied at 26. You're listening to Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
What would you do if they put you in power? Would you make toll roads free or use the express line when you have more than 15 items? How about lowering your gas prices? The BP Visa with Pump Rewards does just that. Use it virtually everywhere, and you can save when you fill up. Apply today at BP.
Account subject to credit approval. Restrictions and limitations apply. BP Visa credit cards are issued by Chase Bank USA NA. See application located inside the station for pricing and rewards details. Purchases made at merchants where non-BP gasoline is sold do not earn rewards.
Come check out the amazing deals at the Winning Edge in Rochester. With the winter sports season here, they have all the gear you need. The January specials, and to get you in the mood for spring, 25% off all bats and 50% off all bags, backpacks, and duffels. The Winning Edge offers major apparel brands, Adidas duffel and backpacks, Under Armour and Russell apparel, and so much more. Visit their webpage, thewinedge.com, or their Facebook page. Call 574-223-6090. Quality products, unique customizing options, and friendly service from the Winning Edge, Rowell Place Drive in Rochester.
Zebra Basketball, WROI.
Fourth quarter here at Witco High School. We go to the fourth period, tied at 26.
And it looks like the Zebras inbound coming towards their basket. Again, tied at 26. Zebras feeling pretty good. Witco got a burst at the start of the third quarter. Zebras responded pretty well and have staved off the foul trouble, and everybody should be good to go pretty much. Alex Carrick only has 3 fouls. He's the only one really in trouble. And Witco back into, it looks like, a 1-2-2 or 1-3-1 half-court trap.
And Corn drives the baseline, skip pass to Medina. He loses the shot on the way up. He gets the basketball back, puts it up on the glass. It's good, and we're up by 2.
Does he get the assist to himself as
Absolutely.
Well?
Absolutely.
Okay.
28-26. That works in the bigs, right?
I think it does.
Rochester matches their biggest lead of the night of 2 at 28-26. They're in the 2-3 zone. The ball's tipped around. Bennett comes out of there with it. Ball's being still tipped around, and Kennedy knocks it out of bounds as Bennett tries to save him going out of bounds and hits it right into the hands of Kennedy, who loses it out of bounds. So Witco going to get possession baseline right.
The zone's been good for the Zebras, but not because they're playing lazily. They're actually getting more deflections in the zone because they're playing aggressively but smart.
Oh, Stoddard is fouled on the shots as the official across court. Kennedy, oh, that's just a bad call. And Luke Kennedy picks up foul number two, but more importantly, sends Alex Stoddard to the line for two.
Yeah, as a coach, you got to hate where a foul underneath the basket's called by the guy who's the farthest
from
the play.
That's not good.
It's going to be Luke's second, team's third of the half.
Stoddard's free throw is good. 28-27 Rochester, 7:40 to play in the game. Tony Stasiak, I'm David Musselman. We are at Whitco High School for the second conference game of the season for both schools. Second by Stoddard is good again. We're tied at 28, and Whitco will use a 60-second timeout. You're listening to Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
Smith Farm Store is your locally owned winter headquarters. Whether your winter needs include a snowblower, stove, or furnace, or you're in the market for a new steel chainsaw or gun safe, or you just need the basics like a chimney sweeping log or ice melt, Smith Farm Store is the only stop you need to make. Smith Farm Store of Rochester has moved next door to 151 Rochester Plaza in the old Kroger building. Smith Farm Store, your friendly local hardware store in Rochester and Plymouth.
New Holland T7000 series tractors from New Holland Rochester take tractor performance to new heights with groundbreaking power, best-in-class hydraulics, and high-visibility horizon cab. These 135 to 180 PTO horsepower tractors offer the new fast steer turning option, a must-have feature for row crop or loader work. It lets you make a full right or left turn with only a 10-degree nudge of the steering wheel. Step up to a new level of performance with the New Holland T7000 tractor from New Holland Rochester, Highway 25 South.
Zebra Basketball, WROI.
Back at Whitco High School, 7:20 to play in the game. We're tied at 28. And after the Wildcat timeout, the Zebra will have it going to our left. Alec Holland gets it into Screeton. And a little pressure, man-to-man pressure by Whitco. Screeton works against Stoddard, walks it through the center circle, going to our left. We're tied at 28. Screeton backs it out to the center of the circle, picks up the loose ball. Now with Stoddard in his jersey, has the ball tipped away, and Cumberland cannot save him from going out of bounds. It'll go back to Rochester right in front of the Whitco bench.
Zebras had done, other than the beginning of the game, had done a pretty good job against the Whitco. Don't afford those turnovers when you fought so hard to get into this game and have a tie game and have a careless turnover cost you an easy bucket.
Holland works in the backcourt against Cumberland. Nobody's moving for Rochester. Holland around the defense, throws up a shot, a lot of contact, no foul, and the rebound by Weber, who gives to Cumberland. Did you see the same thing? A lot of Zebras standing around watching that trip.
Yeah, nobody's really helping out the ball handlers, and that's tough as a ball handler. You feel like you're out on an island if nobody's going to cut to get you open. No screens either.
Fly pass down to Powell, his shot over Medina, no good. Kennedy with a board. And now Luke gives to Screeton. A lot of contact down low as well on that end. No call. Screen against Stoddard. Boy, I tell you what, Stoddard is in the jersey of Carter Screeton. And Medina to Korn. Korn runs down the loose basketball. Regains the dribble. Works against Powell, the man-to-man defense. High on the left side to Alec Holland. Holland against Cumberland. Loses the handle, and Cumberland picks up the loose ball. He'll go in. Right-handed layup is good, and Whitco back up by two at 30-28.
That's Whitco's best offense is Cumberland creating havoc in transition. The Zebras got to be able to solve that. If not, it's going to be tough to finish this game out.
Screen is then body-checked by Cumberland, and we'll see with the Rochester Zebras out of bounds. A 5:45 to play in the game. Whitco by two at 30-28.
That's Cumberland's third, team's third. Now, if you can use that aggressiveness against him now, he's got three fouls. If you can go right at him and protect the ball, pick up that fourth, then you kind of change the dynamics of the Whitco team because they're a completely different team when he's not on the floor.
Yeah, you're right. Odell and Alec Herrick back into the game for Rochester. Odell's been really quiet this game. I think he has, what, six? Is that what you said, Tony?
Yeah, Odell had eight. He had six in the third quarter. Okay. So he's eight for the game.
Odell backs his way in, throws up a shot, and is blocked out of bounds by Bennett. And it'll stay with Rochester baseline right. And that's one thing we talked about in the holiday tournament, where Rochester very seldom uses a head fake.
Yeah, I was just going to say that. They don't have the height or the length to shoot over these guys. They need a good shot fake to get them off their feet.
Great inbound play by the Zebras. Screeton finds Odell for an easy two. We're tied at 30.
Odell now in double figures with 10, leading scorer for the Zebras.
5:15 to play in the game. Rochester in a 2-3 zone. Cumberland walks it through the center circle. Right side to Weber. Back to Cumberland, top of the key. Back to Weber, right side. Wide open three over Odell is no good. And off the top of the backboard, thankfully, for Whitco, they got another offensive board.
Yeah, and I'll tell you what, the Zebras for all the talk about Weber being able to knock down the threes, and he's hit, he hit his first one, and he hit one in the third quarter. But as the halves have gone on, he's probably, I'd say, 2 for 8,
yeah,
2 for 10 in that range. He's not as strong as I thought coming into the game.
Under 5 to play, we're tied at 30. Rochester's basketball going to our left. Alec Garrick with the basketball gives back to Alec Holland in this corner. He'll take a long jumper off the front of the rim, no good. Bennett with a rebound. Probably a too quick of a shot for Rex Reinhold's taste.
Yeah, you know, it kind of opened, but again, from 17 feet from the angle.
Nice recovery by Alec Garrick, who knocked the basketball out of bounds on the cross-court pass from Weber, I believe. Make that Cumberland, I believe. And it's going to stay with Wick on the far side as Alec Holland comes out and Hallischel back in.
Yeah. Sometimes freshmen don't always make the best choices. Coach Holmes is going to talk to him a little bit maybe about, you know, hey, let's move the ball a little bit. You probably get that shot later in the possession, too.
I think that this is by far Jacob Hallischel's best game this year.
Yeah, he's been pretty consistent both offensively and defensively.
So as Weber gets the basketball, goes to the basket hard, he has fouled before. The shot will be out of bounds to the Wildcats. With 4:27 to play in the game, we're tied at 30 here at Witco.
Fouls on Hodgeville, his second, Zebra's fourth of the half.
Weber, baseline right, looks to get it in. Lobs it into Bennett. Bennett against the double team, back out to Cumberland. Cumberland body checked on the sideline by Odell.
That's going to be Odell's second. Zebra's fifth. Got to be careful now. They had stayed out of foul trouble most of this half, but that's one where you're right in front of the referee and you use your hips to kind of body check the dribble.
Right.
They've been calling that all night. You've got to make the adjustment and back off.
Cumberland to Stoddard. Stoddard around the defense. Top of the key, outside to Weber. Back to Cumberland between the rings. Make that to Stoddard between the rings. Now inside the arc, hesitates, goes around the defense, cut off of the defense, gives to Bennett down low. Backs his way in. Ball taken away by Creighton, and Bennett fouls Creighton hard. And I believe that'll be Witko's fourth team foul.
Yep, the Witko's fourth, Bennett's second. So really nobody in foul trouble for Witco. Cumberland has three. That's the most. Bennett has two.
Rochester will use a 60-second timeout. You're listening to Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
Terrorist attacks, war, floods, and tornadoes. Our lives have always had to confront major catastrophic events. Christians accept the fact that these events happen and talk about them with Jesus Christ. We also share the positive things that happen when one of the advantages of knowing Jesus as your personal Savior. Find out more about this by attending one of our services at Grace United Methodist Church on Saturday at 5:30 p.m. and Sunday at 9:30 a.m. Our church is located at the corner of 7th and Jefferson Streets in Rochester.
Jennings Insurance, your professional Pekin insurance agency located in Argus and Rochester, believes in the game of life. It pays to make sure you're safely covered with insurance. They can help you cover all the bases, whether it's auto, homeowners, life, business, health, or an annuity. At Jennings Insurance, they'll help you compare rates and prices. That's Jennings Insurance and Pekin teaming up to help you plan ahead for protection against those unexpected plays in the game of life.
You've been waiting for the right time to buy a new vehicle. The time is now with the Big Finish 2012 at Braun Chrysler Dodge Jeep and Ram in Winnemac. The new 2013 Chrysler 200 is an affordable mid-sized vehicle with great fuel economy and up to a $3,500 rebate. Braun Chrysler has several to choose from, including the 200, 200S, and 200 LTD. Make a bold move. Take advantage of the Big Finish 2012 at Braun Chrysler Dodge Jeep and Ram, US 35 South in Winnemac. Online at Braun Chrysler Dodge Jeep.com.
Zebra Basketball, WROI.
4:03 to play in the basketball game. We're tied at 30, and the big man just picked up his third personal foul.
Yeah, another blocking foul. Both teams have to make these adjustments.
Alec Garrett goes to the basket hard, makes a short circus shot to put the Zebras up by two.
Nice reverse. So that's, he used the rim. The big guy couldn't block the shot because he used the reverse layup and used the rim to actually help protect the big guy from blocking his shot. Nice move.
Long three for Weber's. No good. And the basketball is knocked out of bounds as Bennett climbs the back of Odell. Again, no call, but Bennett knocks the basketball out of bounds. It'll go back to Rochester up by two with 3:40 to play in the game.
Witco going to bring the pressure, but interesting to see what Rochester does here. Not very many times this year have they had a lead in a close game late. How do they handle that? How much clock do they run? Do they look to run offense? Can they handle the ball without turning it over? This is a big spot for
them. Here's what I'm surprised Wicklow hasn't done anymore here, especially late in this game. That half-court trap has worked for them tonight.
Right, and they're not in foul trouble. They're not in danger of sending the Zebras to the free throw line.
Jeff Torrance, pull it over for the elbow is good. That's a good, hard move by Seth Korn, the senior, and he put his Zebras up by four.
That's a decisive move that you count on your seniors to make in a crunch time game.
Stoddard high on the right side, 3:10 to play in the game, Rochester by four. Weber has a shot blocked, but I believe Korn has picked up a little arm as well, and so that's going to send Weber to the line for two for the Whitco Wildcats.
You know, I thought Seth had played good defense. If you're not going to try to take the charge, which he wasn't, he kind of backed off and tried to kind of reach around. And I think he had a good defensive possession until he kind of pump faked, and then he drew the contact on the arm.
Weber at the line for two. First on the way is good. 34-31 Rochester, 3:06 to play in the game.
Weber now joins the double figures club with 10.
Weber with one more, looking to cut the Rochester lead to two. He does not do it. Man, Wicklow with another, got their hands again on an offensive board, but couldn't keep it from going out of bounds. Rochester will get it back and facing the full court press.
Another topic for another day is they should let you go back to start blocking out when the ball releases the shooter's hands. If you want the fundamentals of a block out, you got to get that back in.
Rochester then turns it over. Stoddard with the basketball going to R.I. I'm with you, Tony. I agree. If you're quicker off the block, offensively or defensively, you're going to get the rebound. And right now, Whitco quicker of the two teams.
Right.
Stoddard fakes the three, drives around the defense, pulls up on the baseline, jumper no good, and Garrick gets the rebound.
There you go.
2.5 to play in the game. Rochester up by three at 34-31. Oh, pass is almost stolen, and the ball's loose again. A lot of bodies flying around on the floor. No foul. Rochester loses it out of bounds, and the Wicklow Wildcats going to get it back. Rochester down to their final two timeouts.
And Wicklow just took their third one, so both teams are going to have two timeouts for the last 2:26.
2:26 to play in the basketball game. The 30-second break. You're listening to Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
Coca-Cola Bottling Company of Plymouth wants you to enjoy your world, especially now that basketball season has returned. So before heading to the gym or after the big game, even listening on the radio or watching on TV, enjoy the good times with family and friends and Coca-Cola. Grab the refreshingly clean taste of Coca-Cola, Diet Coke, Coke Zero, Sprite, and Sprite Zero. When you get together for exciting times, make sure you have plenty of terrific Coca-Cola products on hand, whether it's the store or the vending machine. Coca-Cola products go great with anything you do. It's the real thing. It's Coca-Cola.
Zebra Basketball, WROI.
2:26 to play in the game, 34-31 Rochester. And after the Whitco Wildcat timeout, they'll have the basketball going to our right. Tony Stasiak, I'm David Musselman.
Neither team in foul trouble. There's no players on either team that have four fouls. Zebras come out in a 2-2-1 half-court trap.
And the Rochester Zebras create a turnover. Seth Korn on the baseline, loses the handle, picks up the basketball outside to Streeton.
Great move by the Zebras. They hadn't shown that half-court trap at all coming out of the timeout. Whitco wasn't ready for it. The Zebras got a turn, got a turn.
Odell outside. Rochester going to run some clock with up by three. We'll see what they're made of here.
Yes, they haven't had a chance to run the delay game yet this year.
Down to under 2 minutes to play in the game. Streeton just about loses the basketball and out of Korn. Seth Korn over the defense to Streeton.
The big thing here is just get the ball to the open person. Don't be picky. You see a black shirt pop open, get them the ball, and step towards your pass. You got to meet your pass. Don't wait for the ball to come to you.
Wide open layup to Hadashell. He's fouled on the shot by Cumberland, and Hadashell will go to the line to shoot two.
Man, that's going to be Mr. Cumberland's fourth foul, so he's the first player and a key player to have four fouls. It's a 16 foul, but it's a shooting foul, so Hadashell's going to go to line for two. Need to hit at least one here to get it to a two-possession game.
First one on the way off the back of the rim, no good.
Hadashell, not many free throws this year. That's only his eighth attempt. He was 2-for-7 coming into this game, make it 2-for-8. Big to hit this one here.
Second one on the way, good. Two-possession game now for Whitco as the Zebras up by four with 1:38 to play in the game.
And change defenses once again. Back into the regular 2-3. Now they come out and show the blitz again. 2-2-1.
Stoddard around the defense on the baseline. Skip pass to Weber. His jumper no good. Powell the rebound. He puts it back up. It is good. And now Whitco will use a timeout. It's a 60-second timeout. Rochester by 2, the minute 22 to play in the game. You're listening to Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
Your Fulton County REMC is proud to offer the new Faster Exceed satellite internet service. They can now connect customers to their fastest satellite internet service ever with broadband speeds up to 12 megabytes per second. For homeowners with fewer options for internet service or who live in rural areas, there's no better option than Exceed Broadband. Share photos remarkably fast. Enjoy better video chat with less jitter. Send and receive files quickly. Exceptionally fast web browsing and email. Listen to streaming music. If you're ready for a faster internet connection, you're ready for Exceed Broadband. Call 574-223-3156 today to learn more about the amazingly fast Exceed Broadband service offered by your local Fulton County REMC, your Touchstone Energy provider.
Zebra Basketball, WROI.
1:22 to play in the game. Rochester clinging to a two-point lead. It's 35-33. And after the Whitco timeout, Rochester will have it, needing to go the length of the floor.
Yes, Whitco only has one timeout left. Rochester has two. Both teams are shooting free throws the rest of the way. Whitco has the possession arrow.
The way the Whitco Wildcats cut the lead was an offensive board and a putback by Powell. Boy, that has been their Achilles heel all year.
Yeah.
Man-to-man pressure. Here comes a little
Don't
trap.
Away from him.
Derek gets away from the defense. Gives a head to screen with a minute 10 to play in the game. Rochester by 2. And Corn just about dribbled the basketball on the timeline. Now to Odell. Odell around the defense. Here comes the triple team. Split the defense. Down low. Shot is blocked from behind by Powell. Picked up by Garrett. Outside the screen with under a minute to play in the game. Hadashaw gives to Garrett. Kicks it out the screen to the timeline. Down to 50 seconds to play in the game. Rochester by 2 at 35-33.
Oh.
And Cumberland just fouled Hadashaw.
And he just fouled out.
That's a big foul out.
That is huge.
And Hadashaw will go to the line to shoot one of the bonus with 50.3 to play in the game with Rochester up by 2.
The one guy that could create havoc defensively, could create off the dribble and get everybody else open looks, just took him out of the lineup for Whitco.
And Kessie comes in, he played some time in the JV, so obviously you lose the experience and the ball handling of Cumberland, and Rochester Jacob Hadashaw the line for one of the bonus. First on the way is up and good.
Good. Hopefully Jacob found his rhythm here after making the second of his last two attempts, because this, again, big gets a two-possession game. So even if Whitfield comes down and hits a three, you can still inbound the ball with the lead.
36-33 Rochester. Hadashaw with one more. Second one. Good again. Four-point lead for Rochester. 50 seconds to play. Stoddard in the backcourt. Brings it up the floor. Crosses the timeline with 45. Gives outside to Weber.
Got to find your shooters.
Now to Stoddard with 40. Behind the arc, left corner. Over the defense to Weber with 35. In the corner to Kessie with 36. Back to Weber with 34. Weber, cross-court pass to Stoddard. Fakes the three. Pulls up 15-footer on the way. Is in and out. No good. Odell loses the handle. Garrick scrambles for the rebound and gives to Odell, and Rochester uses his timeout with 24.8 to play in the game. It's a 60-second break. Rochester by 4. You're listening to Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
For profit or not for profit, it may not seem like it matters. However, if you're selecting a hospice organization, it can make all the difference in the world. At Hope Hospice, we are a not-for-profit, public-benefit healthcare option. All of our focus can freely be given to our clinical services and the nurses that tend directly to your loved one's needs. We do not have to worry about cutting costs or running minimally staffed programs in order to profit someone else. Our only concern is how well our patients are cared for. When selecting a hospice organization, select Hope Hospice at 224 Hope or visit us online at hopehospicefce.com.
WROI Rochester.
Why do people love Nubiano's famous Italian pizza so much?
It makes me happy.
The gooey cheese.
The hand-tossed crust.
The toppings.
The homemade sauce.
The taste.
I don't know. I just love it.
Call Nubiano's at 223-4224. That's 223-4224. Dine in, carry out, and delivery is available. Don't forget, they also have delicious hot baked sandwiches and salads, too. Nubiano's Italian Pizza, 714 East 9th Street, Rochester, a Fulton County tradition since 1982.
Zebra Basketball, WROI.
24.8 to play in the game. John Odell gets the basketball inbounds, up by 4. Odell goes to the basket, dumps down little court, hits jumper, short on the foul! And this four-point lead is now gone to 6, and sets Corn to the line, is trying to stretch this baby to 7 with 20 seconds to play in the game. missile's going to be on, looks like, pretty signal. We don't have a...
Kathy.
Okay, 25. All right.
Seth Korn of the line for one, looking to push this lead to seven. The senior shoots, it's good. 40-33, biggest lead of the night for Rochester. 18 seconds to play. Weber for three in the corner. It's in and out and back in. Timeout, Whitco. 40-36. It's a 60. It's a 30. We'll keep it right here. It's a 30. We'll keep it right here. Rochester up by four with 14.1 to play in the game. Whitco now, Tony, out of timeout.
Out of timeouts. They do have the arrow. So Coach Ryan holds drawn up a play. Probably try to get some screen. The big thing is to get the ball in bounds. If you need to use a timeout, the Zebras have one left. Possession inbounds is the most important thing, and then step to meet your pass and be ready because they're going to have to foul. So you want to set some screens, set legal screens, get the ball in bounds, use the timeout if you need it, and if you can get the ball in bounds, then step into the line. But you've got to make sure you get that ball in bounds first and foremost.
It'll be Odell, Garrick, Screeton, Korn, and Hanna showing the floor for the Rochester Zebras. They will need to go the length of the floor. 14 seconds to play in the game. Rochester by four. Hattershell will trigger the inbounds pass against the full-court press. Tony Stasiak, I'm David Musselman. Hattershell looking to get it in. Still looking to get it in. And he's going to have to use a timeout.
Yep.
I thought he had Odell streaking through the lane. It's a 30. We'll keep it here again. I thought he had Odell, but couldn't get it to him. Couldn't pull the trigger.
Yeah, nice confidence in Coach Reinholz to put a sophomore. That's a big spot to put a sophomore inbounding the ball like that. Good decision. As a coach, you want to make sure you make that pass. If there's a doubt about whether that guy's open or not, with the timeout left, you might as well err on the side of caution, take the timeout. Now, with no timeouts left, you can't be as choosy. Probably try to see how else you can counter that now. Maybe try to run somebody deep or maybe run a double screen or do something like that. Once again, no timeouts left, so you've got to get the ball bounce or throw it off somebody's leg to try to save the possession.
Yeah. 14 seconds of play in the game. Rochester up 40-36. Every one of the five guys in for Rochester can shoot. So whoever gets fouled can walk to the other end and shoot free throws.
Good, and this is where you see the Cumberland foul-out situation, I think, hurt him because he was almost a one-man pressing himself, harassing and being able to get up on the ball just by himself. And now without him, Whitco's a lot slower. And it looks like maybe some double screens for Odell or trying to get the ball in bounds, maybe cutting to the ball and somebody cutting away.
Panachal will look to get it in. Does so to Odell, and he's found immediately by Powell with 13.7 to play in the game. And Odell will walk to the other end of the floor, and he'll shoot one of the bonus. Zebras lead by four at 40-36 here at Whitco High School.
As we talked before the game, what you'd like your seniors to do, both the Zebra seniors are in double figures. Seth Korn has 11, and John Odell also has 10, looking for his 11th point of the night.
Free throw by Odell is no good. Rebound to Bennett. Quickly ahead to Stoddard with 10. Stoddard, three, top of the key, no good. Rebound to Powell, he puts it up, and it's good. 3 seconds
to
play.
Hold on, don't even inbound.
2 seconds to play, and that's going to do it. Rochester and the head-to-heady John Odell did not inbound the ball when he saw there was less than 5 seconds to play in the game, and the senior, the veteran, held on to the basketball and let the clock tick away to nothing, and Rochester hangs on to win here at Whitco High School, 40-38. Post-game thoughts after this on 92.1 WROI.